Assalamu alaikum, dear students of class 6th. Dear students, in the previous video, we discussed some of the adaptations of the aquatic plants, those plants which live under the water. And those plants which are aquatic, some of them have submerged in water, some are totally submerged in water, and some have the parts over the surface of water, meaning some are floating over the water. So as you know that these plants have a hollow stem, they have a light stem, and their leaves and flowers float on the surface of water. So dear students, there are some aquatic plants which are totally submerged in water. That means there not any part is above the water. That means they are totally submerged in water. All parts of such plants grow under the water. Some of these plants have narrow and thin ribbon-like leaves. Ribbon-like leaves. They can bend in the flowing water. In some submerged plants, leaves are often highly divided, through which the water can easily flow without damaging them. So dear students, in some of the plants which are totally submerged in water, they have a narrow and thin ribbon-like leaves, and these leaves can bend in the flowing water, and they have these leaves are highly divided, meaning the water can flow easily through them without damaging these plants. So dear students, similarly, frogs usually have ponds as their habitat. Frogs can stay inside both the pond as well as on the land. They have strong back legs with the help of them in leaping and catching their prey. They have webbed toes with the same in water. So the frogs, they are amphibians, meaning they can float, they can live in water as well as on the land. In the water, they have webbed toes which help them to swim in the water. So dear students, these are some of the adaptations with which these aquatic plants or these aquatic animals live in water.